Yosemite? Is that you?
No, I'm an intruder, here to desecrate your federal property.
Shh. Not so loud. The others are sleeping.
Oh. I didn't know.
Well, don't just stand there. You're letting all the cold air in.
My teeth keep falling out. Yum.
Look.
There's something broken in me, isn't there?
Welcome to the club. Now sit down. I called you selfish earlier.
You did?
It's not damning.
It should be, though. I know what I am.
You do?
Of course. I'm selfish. Vindictive and scared. In my crisis, I drag down others to my low. Make them as afraid and uncertain as me.
It's true. You're all of those things. I've been right about you since day one. It's fine, though. I am too.
Well, you are only human after all.
Yosemite! Wherever are you hiding? Oh dear me. If she doesn't appear soon, I won't be able to tell her a story. Our picnic will be ruined. Whatever shall I do?
Wait! I'm right here! I want to hear this story!
Oh, I'm not so sure now. It's getting rather late. Perhaps we should return to the cabin.
Preposterous!
It's preposterous, dear.
Preposterous! Please, Zion! I want to hear the story about the swallow again! Tell me the swallow story!
Goodness. I suppose I have no choice then.
No, you certainly do not!
Very well. Come sit down, little one. You can't listen to a story from all the way over there, now can you?
Coming!
Straighten your posture.
But Zion, must I really?
Only if you respect yourself.
Now?
Once upon a time, there was a poor man in a field. In the past, he had been quite popular, but rambunctiousness had gotten the better of him, and he had spent all his valuable possessions, including his clothes. While wandering the endless field, he saw a swallow overhead.
You don't come back from this, not like before. Desolation loves all who knocks on her door. Ghost stories for supper time, hope was for tea. Ain't it so nice to be shackled and free?